So Johan, when we did the last stuff and it was distorted, was that going directly? I asked you this before, but was it going directly in or was it going from the microphone?
No, it was. Well, it was going through this microphone.
Right there, right?
Yeah.
I'm thinking maybe to put it somewhere way farther away, or maybe just kind of give it a...
Well, the very first time when it was there, it was cool. It didn't pick up that feedback. So I don't know if it was just because it was louder or not. Yeah. And I haven't messed around with the settings. I don't know if it moved up, like, when I took the battery out, if it went to a default higher sensitivity setting, because it seems like it's a different setting than the one that I dialed down, but I have to look on my computer right now to see where the thing is. So, but yeah, that's a... I mean, you know, it would be good to stick it over here if we had a hook and I could just hang it down from right there, besides what's on tape.
Yeah, what I'd like to get Mark to do, too, is actually take these monitors and actually spread them out. Manic depressive stuff there. But it's, you know, spread them out a little bit so you got more of an oral, because everything, I mean, right now it's just basically for your ears, and, you know. See, that's loud.
Voice recorder where it's decent enough for me makes it so much faster just to be able to stick it onto my computer and play around with it as I learn how to do everything. So yeah, moving it around.
Yeah, I like the idea too, you know, just put stuff down for you, because then what if you like the stuff that we're doing, you can go, hey, let's...
I like everything that you guys play. So, and I liked at the very beginning, it might be that psychedelic rock that you guys are talking about, where it was kind of, when people were asking me what kind of music we were doing, when it was at the very beginning, I told them it was like dirgy grunge. It was rockish, but then it had some kind of, you know, sort of elongated areas, and maybe that's the, you know, the layers of what you're calling psychedelic without the other stuff, but I think it's really fucking cool. I like that. So if I could fit what I'm doing in terms of my tone into the music you're playing.
When we were playing at Gilman Street, a lot of times what I would do is, you know, because everybody was looking at a punk rock band and playing hard, when I got up there, what I would do is I'd do this. Marcus get pissed off because he goes, don't do that pretty shit, I can't play, you know. But there's a couple other friend of mine that I used to let him borrow my amp, he'd start doing the same thing, and what it does is it's kind of weird, because when you're in the crowd and you see that happen, you know, when I was upstage, I wasn't hearing what the reaction was, but, you know, people would, like, trip out already just from doing, like, a chord. You know? Oh, blah, 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 blah. And then you just pop into your shit. It's like...
psychology. But I still want to be able to do some hard stuff.
I'd love to do some hard stuff.
Well, it'd be fun if...
No, I'm listening to you.
No, just... it's.
But it'd be fun to do what?
I'm not doing it again. I'm not saying it again.
Come on, dude.
I'm not saying it for the 20th time.
Dude, I've had 3 cups of coffee.
I know. Got it.
It's all your fault. I don't drink coffee, but it's your fault. What was I doing? I don't remember. It would be oopy-dee-ba-dee-ba-dee-ba.
Don't bring me down.
It's the Super Shop shit. Super Shops. That's funny. The more I start listening to or remembering the Minutemen.
Yeah, I like them.
Because my first concert was the Minutemen with Mark. And it was like, all of a sudden, I love the way that guy played without... Yeah, it was just like... you know, and the bomb...
Yeah.
It's it's all trivial, but it's, I'm starting to, even now at 42, I'm starting to realize where my influences really did come from at a certain bar before.
Yeah.
Enough for you? It'd be louder. Cause I'm gonna, I'll bring up the drums. So I was gonna bring the whole volume up there.
Yeah, do it.
Okay. Make sure it's not too loud for. These, by the way, these fucking speakers.
Yeah.
Rock, dude. Yeah, these are good. I actually got these. I was working for a company that made these speakers.
Yeah.
They do. They rock. We got. Well, see, that's from the.
Those are the ones I got for my computer.
The Yamahas?
Oh, no, I got the Alesis.
The Alesis?
Yeah.
So these aren't the ones that I gave Mark then.
Well, I don't know. About, I don't know what you gave Mark. I'm just saying. Remember those ones that I hooked up to my computer?
Yeah.
Those
are, yeah, so the motherfuckers are good for, I mean, for the amount of money.
Yeah. That's what Mark told me. That brand is known for doing, like, higher and cheaper, you know, your entry stuff. But you still get pro-level access, not just a slightly lower.
So you see how I got the levels now for the drums?
Yeah.
You got a barely low, you know, that's pretty much standard.
Yeah.
And the way that the trim is just, it's about 9 o'clock. And then you can bring up your volume here. Yeah, because then I can bring it down here, but I still got some high end here, so that's why I'm not pushing the volume. When you look at your levels there, usually that's pretty good. You start getting a little bit in the red, you know, not too bad. Recording. Like, I think the one time that we went into your unit, it was some red hardcore, dude. I mean, on the levels, I was watching that. I was like, damn, I can't figure out how that.
Yeah.
But.
Well, we also turned it way down. But it wasn't changing, that's right. That's
yeah,
right.
Yeah,
well,
there was some weird kind of.
Yeah, something wasn't connected, right?
We'll be right back.
when you did that pick thing across the strings before you started going. When you just went.
Oh.
Yeah, that was right.
At the end of it?
Toward the end, yeah, before the last couple of minutes.
Oh, yeah, going from the bottom up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, that's another secret. You get like a D chord, right? You want to pick up chicks? You want the campground, you know, and all the fires are going on. And all you need to do is make sure you got your D thing.
Yeah.
Of course, it's out of tune, but... So do what? Let's drop E. God, I haven't done this in a long time.
Thank you.
If you want to bring the drums down lower, or
do what you want. You're on a solo mission. I'm just gonna test the microphone in different ways. Thank you.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay. Yeah, I just got to pee.
You just what?
You got to pee. Oh. So what do you think? I mean, is there anything there you can maybe use? Or?
Probably. It seemed like you were experimenting more than than other stuff. So we're going for a second little session.
So should I do the first mood and just kind of repeat it and see...
Yeah, just
what
give
you
me
feel
a,
like?
Yeah, give me a little
okay.
bit.
Okay, so the two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, L equals the left, and R equals the right. Side LR is equal to nothing. It is the base where LR equals the populace. Three sides of blah, 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 where two blahs are equal and one blah is, well, blah. The base supports the strut, EL and ER. The strut supports the apex, E. Exterior force to the struts support the apex, E. Interior force between the struts strengthens the apex, E. Interior force upwards from the base, LR, topples the apex, E. Political and economic engineering. The Janus god of desecration and veneration is geometrical proof, reverse psychology, affably utilized by both struts to support the apex. Now maybe I should bring up a chalkboard with me too, because that would be great visually.
Yeah,
so I'll come up there with the thing, with my like notes, right? I'll make little note cards, and I'll draw on there while you guys are doing your thing. And then, so that's the first part, basically.
So at the second part, would you want something a little bit more driving, but not as like, you know, just kind of a nice transition out of the la 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 la? And
well, how would you think? So I could, so you could go straight hard, and I could scream out, "The two-party system is a fucking farce, staged by the elites to engage the actors in frenetic apathy. The magic sleight of hand through by the saw." Why are there no fat fairies? Where are the wheelchair-bound elves? Why are the raccoons talking? While the chorus leads us on. And you can watch me bow, I could get into the kumbaya position. So when I go, kumbaya, my lord.
See, that's where I need to, I know the song, but it's been a while, but that's where I think I need to go into the kumbaya song. Once you go into there, it's like... You know, but obviously, you know, with the kumbaya thing. Yeah, so... Or at the beginning, the... And then it goes back into the... Is that how it went? And then going to the kumbaya thing. Kumbaya, my lord. Bam, bam, bam. Even if I fuck it up a little bit, it...
Doesn't matter.
Right. Yeah. All right.
So let's see. What
people aren't going to figure out how to figure out how to figure. Although no, the R bus are actually people that are paying attention will.
Yeah, and whatever really people can shit. Really. I'm like, what the fuck is that? Yeah. What the hell is that
I'll
all
just
about?
Direct it to Mark. Yeah. Let Mark figure that out.
Let's see. Let's versions. So I guess what I would do. Well, I guess it depends how you want to transition between the different moods, and then how many moods we want to actually have, because they're...
Yeah, you don't want to overload the mood, do you?
Yeah, so there's the lecturing, first three stanzas, and then the next three can be independently different, or it can go just into a, maybe, the lecture mode, slightly intense mode, because they still need to hear the words, so mm-hmm. they can laugh.
Right.
And then... down to the kumbaya, and then I guess you could end the song by doing what you did at the beat.
I got it figured out.
Alright. So you want to try two moods?
So we'll start out with like that. Right, the little mellow mood where you're just kind of...
Yeah, I'm lecturing. So I'll need a... start. So the two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite. L equals the left, and R equals the right. Side LR is equal to nothing. It is the base, where LR equals the populace. Three sides of blah, 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 where two blahs are equal, and one blah is, well, blah. Now the base supports the struts EL and ER. The strut supports the apex E. Exterior force to the strut support the apex E. Interior force between the struts strengthens, apex E. Interior force upwards from the base, LR, topples the apex E. Political and economic engineering. The Janus god of desecration and veneration in geometrical proof. Reverse psychology affably utilized by both struts to support the apex. So I guess now... I would wait because I have two stanzas of something a little more rockish.
So should I just hang out a little bit and then...
And then maybe you build up musically and then I jump in?
That's a little fairyish, but I can do something different. But, I mean, do you want to go like a little bit more cadence after that point, after we're just doing the... Or do we want to stick maybe within the same text of pick a darker note?
How does it feel to you? What do you want to do? Or do you want to actually get into strumming some full chords?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
And that'd be the two-party system is a farce staged by the elites to engage. Actors in frenetic apathy, a magic sleight of hand duping us all. Why are there no fat fairies? Where are the wheelchair-bound elves? Why are the raccoons talking while the chorus leads us on? That's sort of that's copying our Jack and Jill shit right there.
I know.
Which is funny. But, I mean, maybe something like that. Not totally intense, but changing the mood, or maybe not.
Yeah, because I could change it for chords. Anyway. The kumbaya probably would be.
Yeah, that's so rad. That'll be so rad. Yeah.
You know, kind of funky do.
Yeah.
So, okay, so what I'll do is when we get to the Kumbaya part, I'll just go ahead and... You know, not do the right... Oh, I could probably... That's pretty close.
Yeah, that was good what you did. Since there is a geometry involved, I can already choreograph Morgan's two portions. He and this guy, they could lean up against each other. When I say exterior and interior, he could have other people pushing to show the strength of it, mm-hmm. and pushing from inside, toppling it over. And then when the Kumbaya things, they could get in a
circle
yeah. and do something. You know? Yeah. And then in the middle part, they can do whatever they want. So I could sort of already give him that right there. And let him come up with it how he does.
Right.
To reinforce. They could be my board. Instead of using a chalkboard, I draw them.
There you go.
So I can still be talking and going like that, and they go.
We have how many minutes?
10 minutes for the whole thing.
That's not bad. 10 minutes takes that long to set up.
No, because it's just people, a guitar, and me.
Direct box into the...
I haven't even timed how long it takes to even read this thing, but I know, I'm sure it's like, you know, the 2 minute thing tops. We could stretch it out. Do two pieces again. Yeah. All right, so what do you think? So we still haven't really come up with the middle part then. What, how do you want to do that? Do you want to still stay within mellow, but changing whatever you do so it's not totally rockish? That's whatever you think works, grooves well with what you're playing.
Play it, start singing it again.
Okay, so I'll just read the last two rather than the whole thing.
Okay.
The bass supports the struts, E-L, then E-R. The struts support the apex, E. Exterior force to the struts support the apex, E. Interior force.
Okay, let's try it again, I'm sorry.
Okay, so... Triangulation, another take. The two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite. L equals the left, and R equals the right. Side LR, you know what you could do when I say the left and right?
Mm-hmm.
You could also do like a strum.
Mm-hmm.
When I say left, that sounds positive. Mm. And then when I say the right, you could do a mean strum.
Kind
of, so we could fully like,
you're a freak. Go, yeah, I like that. Right, so do the left part and right part, but segue into it. So
it's the second line. So I'll go, the two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, L equals the left, okay. And R equals the right.
So the left would be... And the right would be...
Yeah. So we can make people giggle.
So the left. And the right.
Yeah.
I gotta write this shit down. Okay, Marky Poo.
You can either go with this little blue one.
Yeah, I like the blue one because it's...
But remember, we're recording right now, so you could even say something
right
now, and the voice mic will pick you up.
Okay.
Because it's picking up all our talking.
So what song is this?
This is Triangulation. And this comes from an idea from one of those guys I'm sure you've seen on the internet. He describes the two-party system like a triangle.
Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And he shows the image. So it's definitely a rip-off on his thing, just to put it into some fun. Okay. Two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, L equals the left, and R equals the right.
Okay.
Should I just do that line? Side EL equals?
Yeah.
Okay. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, R equals the right. The one you went up was...
I did. I went down on the first one. Then I went...
Yeah.
So EL... Okay, do it, please.
Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, L equals the left, and R equals the right. Side LR is equal to nothing. It is the base where LR equals the populace. We should do the sound changes on a couple of things, like elite equals a sound, left equals one, right equals one, and then the populace. And then when I say the three sides of blah, 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 where two blahs are equal to one blah, is well blah, and then maybe you do like the ba-doom, boom.
Yeah, right.
We could
right.
turn this in a little more like that as we're doing it.
Yeah, you can kind of give the words a little bounce and a little bit of...
Yeah.
You know, whether or not people are actually paying attention to that, but, you know, I mean... You know,
some people will. They'll notice, yeah.
Well, that's the people you want to hit anyway.
Yeah,
you
know. It's going to trigger...
Cerebral.
It's definitely going to trigger. And then the rest of it doesn't really have anything to do with that, so that's the introduction, and then back into the regular bass of it. From the top?
Yeah, sure.
The two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite, L equals the left, and R equals the right. Side LR is equal to nothing. It is the base where LR equals the populace. Three sides of blah, 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 where two blahs are equal to one blah as well. Blah. But I think the tones that you made in the elite left and right weren't distinct enough.
No, they weren't.
They were still part in the same geometry.
Yeah. So what I wanted to do was I wanted to go... And then on the other one, I wanted to go...
And I can slow down there. I can... If it makes it easier, since we're not going to practice this to death, where I say where E equals the elite, and then I pause and you make the sound, because then it comes down to Peter of the Wolf, Peter and the Wolf. This is what the hunter sounds like.
Right.
So I could actually pause at each spot, and then you make up whatever sound comes to mind that covers the idea.
God, I used to do that fucking song, dude. I had the whole beat on.
Yeah. Alright, so let's see. So I'll take it from the top again and I'll do the pauses. The two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite. L equals the left. And R equals the right.
Still not right.
It sounds cool, but it doesn't convey the... It doesn't convey the... bad and the good.
Okay, so let me see. Alright, so I'm tuned higher up the neck, and then when I go lower... Oh, wait a minute. See, it's gotta be... Fairy-ish for them.
Yeah, which would be good for later on, for sure.
Yeah, I know. Yeah,
it's cool stuff.
But I want something. So the equals the left.
See, it's gotta be lower. I like that one better.
So, how's your
great?
Or,
yeah,
so
that's
like
I don't know if these some are sinister, but maybe I can.
We have elites left and right.
Elites down.
That's a fucking funny word.
But that might be good for the elites, because that puts them all elites. So the people that are the one that you just did
right.
In that way, because it's sort of like a synergistic sound. Mm. And then the left becomes whatever we want to make the that takes both of them
right,
together.
Right. So, flutter, shout, fight. And then,
those are distinct. And what would you say would be the elites if they were both working together? Yeah, that's cool too. I just thought about it, yeah.
Alright, so,
well, can you do it the other way around, where the elite is first, left is next, and right is
that part first?
Yeah. Actually, are you doing the same chord but going down on it for the lefties and then up on it on the righties, or are you changing the chord?
No, it's changing the chord, because that's for the you know, the
hip. Yeah.
Right, and then so now I'm going to E for the, you know, the Republicans. Right. Well, it's been, the next one is just me going, third chord.
Okay, we moved it away from the progression again. It'd be elites, left, and right. So it'd go from the did-did-did that you did to slow, and then to rough, or whatever. Flowers. To... Oh, yeah, that would be the second one.
Or the other way around.
Well, I thought you were gonna still do strum for the left, strum for the right, but the bat for the elites, because they're both working together. That's the left. So I thought that we'd use that for the elites, that style, the quicker, and then the next one would be the mellow for the lefts. And then the next one is for the right, the Republicans.
Do you want to go Fucci, or do you want to go...
No, that would still remain with the two that you originally were doing. There was the soft one, and then the hard, but still the strum. Not...
I'm sorry. So, here's the half-nots.
I don't know where you're going now. We had the two originally. We just were trying to add a third one. So the first one was that, going back to the very beginning, is...
I'm not getting frustrated with you. It's
okay,
myself.
You had the soft going down.
Right.
That was for the lefties. And then you went lower down here, but strummed up for the righties, where it was a raunchier sound.
But down here,
whatever?
Well,
I got it.
I got it.
Sorry.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You saw
it. And you went up, you went, yeah, it made it raunchier sounding. Yeah, that could work. Because it has to be a totally different sound, because we're trying to distinguish between left good, right bad.
So I can either do this and go...
Yeah. Personally, I don't mind how you go about it, other than as long as the mood's there. And the elites is supposed to be the collaboration of both. So right. You have basically the one, the lefty soft, the right, you know, hard, meeting together for the elites in that quick dance together. It doesn't feel flowers enough and bombs enough for the differences. Good too. What you just did, you had a flowery little thing, then you went that. Nah. Is it better for you musically to have the two strums, the left strum and then the right strum, and then go into the elites? Is it better for you musically than the reverse?
I have to try it, so you know.
Because I can change the words, obviously, but I didn't know what musically was working better for you, from going from the lecture to right. making those sounds right. and then moving forward. Let's just try it, since you know what I'm going for those words. I'll cue it, okay. Like we said. So at what point for you does this part start to get on your nerves, where we should just back off? For me, what I would think at this point, sort of take it from the top again, because you found good stuff when we first did it like that. We're getting, it seems like we're detailed, but we both know we're after.
Right.
And that, does that sound...
Yeah, let's just give it a shot.
So you don't get...
Excuse me.
All right. Triangulation. The two-party system is similar to an isosceles triangle, not an equilateral triangle. Side EL is equal to ER, where E equals the elite.
It's a goddamn fucking compressor. Ah! What is good, I mean?
Okay. called the echo that you're using?
Delay.
Is that delay?
Yeah.
I think delay is a good choice for the whole thing.
Slap delay is what they call it.
Thank you. Hold on. I have a bunch of food made at Susie's. All we'd have to do is nuke. I have to eat it, so I didn't expect to be here. I have to upload my stuff.
I don't really care to see Susie.
Okay, I'll go away.
And I guess we could just, I could set it to upload. It'll take most of it.